So the organization theory and behavior, that is the course with us now. So organization behavior and its theory. First we have to know what organization is, then what organization behavior, right? So have you any idea about organization? By organization, then we will go for organization behavior.
Hello? An organization is a group of people working together to achieve on the specified goal.
Right.
Hello.
Right, right, right. Okay, okay. What else? What else? Organization is a group of people who are working together for a particular goal. Right. Is that sufficient? Is that sufficient to be an organization now?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then how can we define modern organization? Because we are studying organization in modern context. Whatever you are telling, that is a traditional definition of organization. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Organization is the association of two or more persons to achieve a common goal.
Okay, okay. If you say two or more persons, they are engaged in a Tirunathamela and one common goal is they will serve. That can be an organization. Have you seen Tirunathamela?
If there is association, then that is also an organization.
Okay, okay. If there is an association, so if you say Lakshari Toiba, it's an organization. Is it an organization? A group of extremists are there and their work is to make extremists work to ruin this nation. Can we call it an organization? Hello?
Hello, sir.
Sir, have you any pen and paper with you right now?
Yes, sir.
Have you any paper and pen with you right now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. As this is a theory class and it is not mentioned with all the theories are only analytical portions, so you have to come or prepared with some pen and paper so that whenever necessary, I will give you some important notes and points. You have to discuss them. That will help you at the time of examination. Fine?
Okay.
Okay. So I am telling very clear definition of that organization. Our course will be introduction of organization, definition of organization, features of organization, functions of organization, principles of organization, and different theories of organization. Today we will cover this much. Fine? Okay.
Fine, sir. Okay, sir.
Then. So far as first one is introduction of organization. Students, organization is not a new concept. It is a very old and traditional concept since introduction of mankind. When human generation, when human civilization begins, at that time the concept of organization was there. But the concept of organization changes from time to time. With the changes in lifestyle, with the changes in ongoing process, with the changes in different aspects, with the changes in requirements, with the changes of habit of the people, of the society. Do you follow me or not? So organization, when we say organization, then it almost depends upon the social process. If any activity...
Sir, what is social process?
I am telling you. So when any activity or when a group of person, when you say a group of person who are associated with themselves for a common objective, it is an organization, right? I agree with that. But the concept of organization changes now. What is that? If activity of a group of people is not approved by the society, and the goal which has been decided by that group of people, not associated with the society, is not meant for the well-being of the society, then we cannot call it an organization. Do you follow me or not? Organization is a process which is approved by the society, and a group of people who are engaged in achievement of a goal. Clear? Do you follow me or not? Hello? Yes, do you follow me or not?
Yes, so yes,
in that context, we can say that every association who are engaged in social well-being can be considered as organizations. Calling the hospital is an organization. IGNO University is an organization. Your family is an organization. Our parliamentary system is an organization. Now you can know the difference about your thinking and the meaning of organization or introduction of organization. Do you follow me or not? Organization means a group of people who associated themselves for the benefit of the society, and they think that the group which has the objective they should be decided, that will be beneficial for the society. Otherwise, it cannot be called an organization. Clear? So the meaning, introduction or meaning of organization say that a group of people, that means a single people, cannot form an organization. Clear? When a group of people associated together, they can form an organization. And these people must have to work together in order to establishment of an objective and achievement of objective. And that objective should be beneficial for the society. If the family, if you consider in that context, that family is an organization. Your family is an organization. My family is an organization. So when we consider in that context, if father alone decide to make a family ideal, can he? Never. If mother alone say that I will make my family ideal, can it be? Not at all. All the family members, that means father, mother, son, sister, uncle, aunt, servant, watchman, if everyone will work together to make family ideal, then only it will be possible on the part of the family to make an ideal family. Do you follow me or not? Do you follow me or not? Okay?
Okay, sir.
Respond. Respond properly so that we can continue. It is interactive class.
Okay, sir.
So, organization means, write down, I am telling. What organization? Definition of organization. Write down. Organization is a social process. Of planning, organizing, directing, and controlling group activities for establishment of and achievement objective in a dynamic environment.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Now read the definition carefully. If you go through the definition, you can easily know the modern concept of organization. What organization mean now?
Okay, sir.
the modern concept of organization, you can easily know what it is. And from this concept, from this definition, you can easily analyze how organization works in our society. And when you say organization, or when you think of organization, when you act organization, it must have to satisfy these characteristics. Clear? Organization is a social process of planning, organizing, directing, and controlling of activities for establishment and of activities in a dynamic environment. Okay?
Okay.
Now you know meaning, introduction, meaning, and definition of organization. Is there any doubt? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Then, on the features of organization. Features. What are the characteristic features of an organization? When you say organization, how it can be? Or how an organization can be worked out in a society? Features. Read the definition carefully, which I have detected you. First feature of organization is, number one, organization is a social process. Write down. Number one, organization is a social process. Over.
Okay, sir.
Number two, planning, organizing, directing, and controlling are the functions. Planning, organizing, directing, and controlling are the functions. Over. Number three, establishment of objective. Establishment of objective. Number three. Number four. Achievement of objective. Achievement of objective. Number five. Dynamic environment. Dynamic environment. Okay?
Okay, sir.
See the features carefully. When we say organization, when we consider organization, it should consist of these five features. So, all the modern organizations now, all the modern organizations, whether it is a commercial organization or non-commercial organization, whether it is a private organization or government organization, whether it is a public sector or whatever may be, all the organizations now must have to fulfill these five characteristic features. Otherwise, we cannot consider as an organization. You follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Let us analyze each feature clearly. Okay, number one. What is number one feature of an organization?
Organization is a social
process. Right?
Organization is a social process. What does it mean? It means every organization or the activity of the organization should be approved by the society. Do you follow me or not?
Sir, voice is not clear.
Voice is not clear. Okay. Social process refers to all the activities of the organization should be approved by the society. Approved by the society in the sense on social,
anti-social
activities.
Just a minute, sir. All of us, please mute your microphone so that you can hear the voice clearly. If all of you will not mute your mic, there will be background noise and nobody can hear that clearly.
So whenever you are speaking, just at that time only unmute the mic. At all other times, kindly mute your mic. Keep your mic muted so that you can hear whatever sir is saying clearly. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Now I am audible. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Number one feature of an organization say it is a social process. Social process say that all the activities or every activity of an organization should be approved by the society. Approved by the society in the sense on social and anti-social activities should not be taken into consideration. If an organization involved in unsocial and antisocial activity, then we cannot call it an organization. Okay? Do you follow me or not? All the activities of an organization should be approved by the society. That means the activities which are carried out by the organization must be beneficial for the society. Society should get benefit out of that. If society will lose, if society will not get benefit, then we cannot call it an organization. Over. So, to be an organization, the primary characteristic is it should be a social process. Social process means whatever activity carried out by an organization must have to be approved by the society. Unsocial and antisocial activities should not be taken into purview of an organization. Clear? Do you follow me or not?
Yes.
And the second one. What is the second characteristics of an organization? What is the second characteristic? Second characteristic say that planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. Have you written or not? Second characteristics of organization say that planning, organizing, directing, and controlling are the functions of an organization. Have you written this or not?
Yes.
Yes. Then we will come in detail when we have separate class of functions of organization.
Yes.
Okay. We have a chapter, functions of organization. In that functions of organization, we will clearly analyze, we will clearly explain what planning is, what organizing is, what directing is, and what controlling is. Okay.
Yes.
Then yes. Third feature of organization say establishment of objective. Third one. This is one of the major important component or feature or characteristics of an organization. Whether it is a small organization or big organization, whether it is a commercial organization or non-commercial organization, whether it is a public sector organization or it is a software organization, every organization's primary characteristic feature is it must have to establish an objective. Clear? Objective means the aim and goal of an organization. Some organizations make long-term objective and other organizations make short-term objective. And organizations are also there who are making short-term as well as long-term objective. So it is said that without establishment of an objective, we cannot call it an organization. Organization must have to establish, organization must have to make, organization must have to decide whatever its objective is. What is its goal? What is its aim? And that aim should be long-term aim or short-term aim or both long-term and short-term aim. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Follow me or not?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Then it is over. Then come to fourth one. Achievement of objective. This is another feature of an organization. Mere establishment of objective does not solve the purpose of an organization. If an organization decides that I will get profit 10 rupees after a month, that is not sufficient. He must have to work accordingly so that at the end of the month, 10 rupees should be its profit. So, achievement of objective should be. Why this session is going on? Why this process is going on? Do you know that? IGNO, its aim is to give education to the unreachables. So when there is an environment, when there is a situation that education cannot be reached to the learners, then online process is being introduced because establishment of objective as well as achievement of objective should be the primary consideration of an organization so that we can call it an organization. IGNO did not sit silently during this pandemic. IGNO is aim is how to reach education to the privileged, to the persons, to the learners who are interested in this university. So they have arranged this process because establishment objective to give education will not solve the purpose. It can only solve the purpose when only the learners will get education, when the learners will get the course, when the learners will be able to appear the exam. Do you follow me or not? So, establishment of objective and achievement of objective, the primary consideration of an organization. When an organization decides an objective, at the same time, it must have to think that how the objective of the organization will be fulfilled. Non-fulfillment of organizational objective should not be considered as an organization. If an organization achieves its objective, if an organization decides its objective, if an organization frames its objective, then it must have to achieve it. Without achievement, we cannot call it an organization. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then we know, you know, number one, social process. Number two, planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. Number three, establishment of objective. Number four, achievement of objective. Then another is with you. That is in a dynamic environment. What is that? Dynamic environment. What do you mean by that? Every organization should provide a suitable working condition to its employees. That is known as dynamic environment, which increases the efficiency of an employee, the efficiency of its members. Dynamic environment. Do you follow me or not? If you think of 10 years before, if you go to a bank, you will find, what is that? 10 people are sitting in front of the bank counter, and each member, each employee assign only a particular job. One is cash disbursement, another is cash received, another is loan disbursement, another is foreign exchange. Do you follow me or not? But now go to a bank. You will find instead of 10 people sitting in a counter, only 2 people are sitting. That is known as single window system. And the person who is sitting is competent enough to do all the work. Disbursement of loan, cash disbursement, receipt of cash, loan, etc., etc., foreign exchange, everything. So this is known as dynamic environment. Now you are experiencing. Without attending classes, you are in your home. And IGNO is providing education to you through online. Dynamic environment. Do you follow me or not? It increases the efficiency of an employee. Dynamic environment refers to suitable working condition should be provided to each and every employee in order to work effectively in the organization so that objective of the organization can be achieved. objective of the organization can be fulfilled. So learners, when you think of an organization, when you go to an organization, when you work in an organization, you always think of, you always decide, you always learn, you always know that if dynamic environment, suitable working condition is not provided to the employees, then that organization is not able to achieve its objective. I am telling the example of banks. Now, if you go to a hospital, within no minute, in 5 minutes, you can get your report, blood pressure report. That is all other reports you will get. Earlier, days together is required to get the report. But now, things have been changed due to dynamic environment, due to suitable working condition, due to favorable working condition. Every organization now decide, every organization now think of how to provide a suitable working condition to its employees so that the employees can work better. And if better employees are there, organization can achieve its objective properly. So when you think of an organization, then it must have to satisfy all these characteristic features. These characteristic features are organization is a social process. Planning, organizing, directing, and controlling are its functions. Establishment of objective is necessary. Achievement of objective is compulsory. And it should be provide a suitable working condition to all its employees. Over. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Then, now you know meaning, introduction, meaning, definition, and characteristic features of organization. Is there any doubt? You know, introduction of organization, meaning of organization, definition of organization, and its characteristic features. Tell me, who is not unable to you, or you are not able to follow? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
You can write, you can answer. Okay. Then come to functions of organization, another chapter. Functions of organization. Students, I have told you that the second characteristic features of an organization is planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. Okay? These are the four functions of an organization. Organization means it must have to plan, it must have to organize, it must have to direct, it must have to control. Without these basic characteristics, without these basic functions, organization cannot act, organization cannot prosper, organization cannot run. Organization cannot develop. Let us see one by one. Planning. Planning is the primary function of each and every organization. What do you mean by plan? Have you any idea about plan?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by plan? Tell me.
It is the act of thinking before doing what we will do in the what we will do in the future.
Right. Right. 50%, 60% right. Okay. Planning is thinking before doing anything. Thinking before doing anything. That is plan. You are planning to secure 90% marks in the exam. Government is making 5-year plan. Some students of ICNO have joined, but they are not planning not to come to class. They have joined in the class process, in the system, but they plan not to come to class. Do you follow me or not?
Yes,
so planning is the primary function of each and every organization. Without planning, organization cannot exist. And that plan refers to thinking before doing anything. I am telling you an example. You are planning to secure 90% marks in the exam. That means exam will be after 6 months. And you are planning from today onwards, deciding the course of action. What you have to do? We saw that the examination will be after 6 months and you will get 90% mark. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Examination will be after 6 months. And you have to make course of action from today onwards. So that you can able to secure 90% mark. Sometimes we say, my plan fails. I have make a failure plan. Why this is so? This is so because your plan is not according to the requirement. According the course of action are not adequate. The course of action is not sufficient. The course of action is not required. Visionary. So your plan fails. For example, when you decide, when you plan to secure 90% marks in the exam and you are very weak in mathematics, what will you do? You are planning to secure 90% marks in the exam, but you are very weak in mathematics. What will you do?
First of all, we have to make strong in mathematics.
Yes. You have to make some course of action. And there are different course of actions are there. What is the course of action for you may not be course of action for me. What is your course of action for A may not be acceptable to B. So course of action should be according to the requirement. What is that? You are very weak in mathematics. So there are different course of actions are available with you. Number one course of action is you can refer good books. Number two is you can go a tuition. Number three, you can devote more time in mathematics. Number four, you can make Xerox and micro Xerox and be copy in the exam. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
There are different course of actions are available for you. And what course of action is available for you may not be suitable for other. So you have to decide what is the course of action that is most suitable to you. For example, you are very poor. You cannot afford money. So if you think that I will go tuition and pay and get 90% mark in mathematics, it will be a defective course of action for you because you are poor. You cannot afford money. You cannot give tuition fees. Okay? You are not hardworking. You are not hardworking. So if you think, if your course of action will be, I will devote more time in mathematics than other subjects, it will be impossible. Because you are not hardworking. Number one, another, you will make micro Xerox and take the Xerox copy to the exam to make copy. If a strict invigilator will be there, it will be impossible on your part to do that. Do you follow me or not? So planning,
yes, sir.
Planning is the primary function of an organization. It involves different course of actions, different steps. If different steps are according to the requirement of the organization, then only planning will be effective. And without an effective plan, organization cannot succeed successfully. Do you follow me or not? Write down. Planning.
Yes,
write down. Two lines. Planning. Planning involves the following steps. Planning involves the following steps. Number one, decide the course of action. Decide the course of action. Number two, both long-term and short-term plan. Both long-term and short-term plan. Number three, coordinate the activity or actions. Coordinate the activities. Okay?
Yes.
So if an organization successfully carry out these aspects, then only its plan will be successful. When we say we are fail in plan, or we have make a defective plan, our plans fails because we are not following these aspects. If these aspects are not carried out properly, then plan will be a failure. Okay? Now you know what plan is? And this is the primary function of an organization. It is the primary function of an organization. Then come to second one. Organizing. What do you mean by organizing?
So it is assembling the resources like man, material, money for the beneficiary of the organization.
Right. To some extent it is true. What else? Organizing. Man, material, machine. If you assemble together, you can be an organizer. But now?
Management also included nowadays.
Things have been changed now. You might have known that. I am giving a morning example. Amit Shah is the grassroots organizer of BJP party. Amit Shah is the grassroots organizer of BJP party. Rahul Gandhi is a failure organizer of Congress party. Why it is so? Men, material, machine, if we say, is organizing, then sometimes it may be a failure. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Organizing. You are deciding to organize a picnic in coming Sunday. You are deciding or you are organizing a picnic in coming Sunday. What will you do? What will you do? When you organize a picnic,
you decide
what are the activities that should be taken off. Do you follow me or not?
Yes.
Transporting is an activity. Marketing is an activity. Cooking is an activity. Singing. Dancing is an activity. Do you follow me or not?
Yes.
So if all the activities are proper, then only you can enjoy your picnic. Otherwise not. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Organizing can only be possible when you can able to arrange all the activities properly. You have to assign the work of marketing to a person who is well acquainted with marketing or who is known about marketing, which goods and commodities are available in which place. If someone does not know ABC of marketing and never see a market, and if you allot that person to do marketing, then your marketing will be a failure. Okay? Same with cooking. If your food is not delicious, you will not enjoy your picnic. And cooking is an art. So you have to assign the work of cooking to a person who is a well cooker, who can make delicious food. If your food is not delicious, you cannot enjoy your picnic. So it is said that you have to allot such a person who is well acquainted in cooking, then only the food will be delicious and you will enjoy your picnic. Likewise, dancing. Likewise, singing. So what organizing is? What is organizing?
Sir, arranging all the resources and utilize them properly.
Properly, right. Write down. Organizing involves the following aspects. Organizing involves the following aspects. Number one, decide the course of action activities. Decide the activities. Number two, allotment of those activities to the most efficient one. Allotment of those activities to the most efficient one. Number three, assign authority and responsibility. Assign authority and responsibility. Very important. Okay. So if all these three aspects are carried out properly, decide the activities, allotment of activities to the most competent one, and assign them the authority and responsibility, then only you can be a good organizer. The work of organizing involves these aspects. Number one is you decide what are the activities are there. Transporting, marketing, cooking, singing, dancing, etc., etc. Number one. Number two, allotment of those activities to the most competent one. The person who does not know cooking, never allot him the work. You should not be a singer. You should not allot the work of singer who does not know ABC of a song. So if you can able to do all these activities properly, then only your organizing will be effective. Organizing can be possible whenever you decide the activities, allotment of those activities to the most deserved one, and make assign authority and responsibility. Clear? Okay?
Yes, sir.
Then come to third one. Organizing. Sir. Then next one is directing. Third one is
directing.
Directing. What do you mean by that? What do you mean by directing? Who can be a director? Have you any idea about a director?
Who know what to do and when to how to do?
Control of the operation.
Okay.
Control of the operation.
Control is something different. We will come again. We will come. Directing. Have you seen films?
Yes, sir.
And then every film has a director?
Yes.
What is the necessity of a director in a film? Have you think of that? Directing is one of the important functions of an organization. Planning is the primary function. Organizing comes next, then third one is directing. Without directing, an organization cannot succeed. The director must be a competent person. The director must have to know what to do and what not to do. You know that Amitabh Bachchan is a superstar. Every film in Amitabh Bachchan, there is a director. What is the necessity of that? What is the necessity of that? Shah Rukh Khan is a superstar. But he needs a director.
Proper guide.
To guide, right? To some extent, to guide. I am telling you another example. It will be more clear. Do you know Yash Chopra?
Yes.
Who is he? What his other name is?
Film director.
Yash Chopra is popularly known as romantic director.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Yash Chopra is considered as romantic director. Why it is so? Why it is so? I am explaining about directing of an organization. How directing can be effective? What is the role of directing of an organization? It is one of the important functions of an organization. Planning, organizing, then directing. Directing is in one of the important functions of an organization. Director must be important. Who give the way? Who is the giving the direction, ways, means to the employees in what way to do? Yes, Chopra is considered as romantic director of films. It is because all the romantic scenes are Yes Chopra are considered as excellent. Then all other romantic scenes of other directors. Clear? Yes Chopra can able to project. Yes Chopra can able to make hero and heroine are romantic scenes of a film in such a way that it makes an impact to the visitors. So it is considered as a romantic director. Do you follow me or not? Vidhu Vinod Chopra is considered as a commercial director. Vidhu Vinod Chopra is considered as a commercial director. Why it is so? Earns more revenue from his film. Do you follow me or not? So director must be a person who must be well acquainted with the following concepts. If the following concepts are known to a person, he or she cannot be a director. When you will join as a director, it is a very crucial job. All are not directors. There are so many good managers are there, but they are not good directors. Managers can only become a director when they know the following aspects. Write down. Directing. Number one, communication. Number two, motivation. Number three, involvement. Okay. Communication, motivation and involvement. That means if a person is not able to know these aspects, these concepts, he cannot be a director. Thank you. Thank you. He cannot be a director. In order to be a director, one must be a good communicator. In order to be a director, one must be a motivator. In order to be a director, one must be involved. Should be involved. Otherwise, he or she cannot be a director. Do you follow me or not? So, yes. Today, the three aspects of a directing is one of the important functions of an organization. Organization must have to communicate. Organization must have to motivate. Organization must have to involve. Clear? All these three aspects are communicating, motivating, involvement are separate chapters in management. If you get a scope to do management in future, then this will be the separate chapters. Communication will take 3 to 4 classes. Motivation will take 2-3-4 classes. Involvement will take 2-3 classes. This is a specialization in HR paper. Communication, motivation, involvement. HR, human resource specialization papers. So for the timing, you just remember that planning, organizing and directing are the functions of an organization. You know what plan is, you know what organizing is, then know what directing is. If you want to be a successful director, if you want to direct properly, if your organization requires a good director, then the person must have to be well acquainted with these concepts. Communication process, motivation process, and involvement process. We will just know the meaning of these concepts. Communication. Tell me what you mean by that. Communication. Very common word with you. What do you mean
sharing
by
communication?
Have you an idea about communication?
Sharing of ideas.
Sharing of ideas, right? What else? What else?
Sharing of ideas, message from one person to another person.
Must be. There must be two persons in communication. A sender and a receiver.
Receiver.
Okay. But this is not for the purpose of an organization in play or in function. A director must be a well-communicated person. It means that sharing of information, write down, communication. Two lines. Communication, two lines. Sharing of informations between two persons. Between two persons. In a particular situation. In a particular situation. Pramodai Kant, namaskar. ठीक अच्छे हाउ रख रख मु क्लास रे अछि त मु अध घंटा पर त मु कॉल बैक करी कहू छी रख मु क्लास रे अछि हां ठीक हां ओके sharing of information between two persons in a particular situation is known as communication.
Communication.
Okay. Sharing of information. Two persons when share their information in a particular time period, that is known as communication. Time period is more important. When you share your information to your father, when you share your information when you are happy, when you share your information when you are sad, when you share your information before your girlfriend, all are different issues, is it not? So say information,
yes, sir,
sharing between two persons in a particular situation. When you are angry, you are sharing of information something different. When you are happy, isn't it? When you share your information before a teacher, and when you share your information with your girlfriend or boyfriend, different. So information sharing depend on a particular situation. So when a person involved himself in directing must have to be well acquainted with the concept of information in a particular situation. If a romantic scene is there for a director and he will give directions to a villain to dance before a heroine, and another director is there who can issue orders or sharing information between hero and heroine to dance, things will be different. Do you follow me or not? So directing, yes, involves, sir, communication. Communication say sharing of information between two persons in a particular time period. Time period is more important. So in a that particular time period, communication should be there so that it can be a good director, or he can be a director, or direction can be proper. Okay. Then another concept is motivation. Very simple word. What do you mean by motivation?
Inspiring, motivation. Inspiring a person to do something better.
Right. What else? You will get 40% mark. Inspiring a person to do something better. Can you inspire a saint to stab anyone, to fire anyone? Can you inspire?
No, sir.
Not at all. Then?
So, inspiring a person in a positive way to achieve good result.
Out of 60 students who have registered in MCO1, only 20 students have come to this online classes. Other 40 students does not require a degree.
Yes.
Why they are not attending online classes? Can you inspire them? No. Students are learners. When you go to an organization, you will find in most of the modern organizations now, all the managers devote 40% of their working hour towards motivating their employees to work better. Motivation is a very difficult task. It's not an easy task. The reason is, you can work for 10 hours in a day, no problem for you. But it is very difficult on your part to make others work for 2 hours or 3 hours or 5 hours. So motivating is such a situation. Motivation is such an aspect which creates an organization better, which makes an organization better. And it is the working necessity of a director. The director must have to be well acquainted with motivation. If he or she cannot motivate others, then he cannot be a good director. And motivation is a very difficult task. And motivation involves make others to take interest in various activity through enthusiasm, motivate. MOTIVATE, motivate. Every letter has its own meaning. M stands for make. A, activity.
Sir, first M.
MOTIVATE, motivate. M stands for make.
Nice.
O stands for others.
Others.
Make others.
T.
Motivate. Take. T stands for take.
Take.
I.
Interest.
Interest. In. P stands for various.
Various.
A stands for activity.
Activity.
T stands for through.
Through.
E stands for enthusiasm.
Enthusiasm.
Okay?
Okay, sir.
So if someone is not enthusiastically interested, you cannot motivate him or her. In order to motivate others, one must have to create, one must have to generate enthusiasm with them. Otherwise, it is impossible to make motivate. So motivation is a very difficult task and it must have to be well acquainted. A person must be well known. A person must have to well practice about that activity. How to make others enthusiastically interested? Otherwise, you cannot. So when you go to an organization, every employee knows that they will work. They are paying money. They give salary for their work. But they are not working due to lack of motivation. And this is due to enthusiasm. They are not enthusiastically interested in working. Out of 60 students who have registered for MCO1, only 20 students are appear in the class. Others are not enthusiastically interested because they know that coming to class and not coming to class make no difference. But when a student, when a learner will feel that coming to class make him different from others, then he or she will definitely attend the class. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
So climbing class is enthusiastically interested, and it is the requirement of a director, it is the necessity with a director to make them interested enthusiastically to the work so that they can work better. Clear? Communication, motivation. The next one is
involvement.
Involvement. What does it mean?
So emotional or personal attachment with someone.
Active participation is involvement. Active participation. When there is an organization, all are not active workers. Some are active partners, workers, and others are passive workers. You might have known that. Remember, partnership in BCom.
Yes, sir.
Partnership. There is a partnership by Stupel. Flipping partner.
Yes, sir.
Active partner. Though that is a partnership form, but their designation is something different. This is due to their involvement in partnership form. Yeah?
Yes.
There is a seminar organized in your class or in your department. Every student participate in this seminar. Out of 30 students, 20 students presented a paper in the seminar, and others are not presenting the paper in the seminar. They just participate. So how can you distinguish with them, the 20 students and the 10 students? The 20 students who participated in the seminar and presented a paper are involved more than other 10 students who are not able to present a paper in the seminar. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
So involvement refers to active participation. Involvement refers to active participation. Clear? So when a director is there, he must have to be well acquainted with the concepts. Communication, motivation, and involvement. If the three communicable concepts are not there, then we cannot make a good director. Our director is impossible. So it is said that all managers are
directors,
workers, but the few managers are directors. You follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
All managers are workers, but few managers are
directors.
Because the concept of communicating, motivating, and involvement is not with a manager, then he or she cannot be a director. And directing. Thank you. Okay. So yes. Now you know planning, organizing, and
directing.
Okay. Then come last one. Sir. Last function is
controlling.
Four functions in an organization. Planning is the primary function. Organizing is second. Directing is third, then fourth one is controlling. Okay, what do you mean by control? Very common word.
Comparing the standard goal with the actual goal, whether it is accomplished or not.
Right. Okay.
The taking corrective measures by seeing the past performance,
right? What else can be controlling? Management has the opinion that controlling is one of the important vital function of an organization. If all the functions are carried out properly, planning is appropriate, organizing is appropriate, directing is appropriate, But if there is no controlling, then all other functions will be meaningless or useless. So there must be a proper control. Controlling is one of the yardstick of an organization. All other functions are depending upon this controlling function. If controlling is not proper, if controlling is not sufficient, if controlling is not time bound, if controlling is not appropriate, then all other functions will be meaningless or useless for an organization. So learners, organization always looking for a good controller. And it is a very difficult task to be a controller. Controlling is one of the important functions, and on this function, all other functions are depending. The effectiveness, result, the fruitfulness of other functions like planning, organizing, and directing depends on the controlling function. Controlling is one of the vital functions of an organization. What is that? I am giving an example. X family controlled by his father. What do you mean by that? X family controlled by his father. Every university has a controller of examinations.
Yes.
What is the necessity of that?
To
the responsibility. Controller of examination. The responsibility given to a authority.
Okay. Responsibility is not with the student in examination. The student has the responsibility.
Yes.
When we say X family controlled by his mother, that is known as mother-dominated family. When you say Y family is controlled by his father, that means father-dominated family. What does it mean? Father is competent enough to justify the activity of every person, every members of the family, and take action accordingly. Do you follow me or not? Controller of examination.
Yes,
controller of examination is competent enough to know different aspects of examination and allot the grade or division to the persons according to their secured mark. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
So controlling is one of the important functions. It involves, write down, three aspects. Controlling involves three aspects. Number one, measure the performance. Measure the performance. Number two, find out the difference. Find out the difference. Third, take corrective action. Okay. So controlling involves these three aspects. Without these three aspects, one cannot be a controller. And controlling is one of the important functions of an organization. Measure the performance. The person must have to know who is meant for what work. What is the role of a finance manager? What is the role of a marketing manager? What is the role of a human resource manager? What is the role of a quality control manager? What is the role of an assistant? What is the role of a sub-staff? What is the role of a watchman? What is the role of a sweeper? Manager must have to know about that. Organization must have to define. Organization must have to know. Organization must have to clarify the performance of a worker. Number one. Number two. Measure the performance. Number two, find out the difference. Why out of three managers, one is not able to achieve the objective? Objective of a finance manager is completely different from objective of a marketing manager. the aim of a production manager is something different the aim of a marketing manager. So the controller of an organization must have to be well acquainted with the performance. The objective of marketing manager should be to achieve the sales target. And the aim of a production manager is to produce qualitative material at the right time. So there is a difference of objective. So when a controller is there, he must have to find out why marketing manager is able to achieve the production marketing sales target and what is the lacuna with the production manager so that he cannot produce qualitative material, qualitative product. Do you follow me or not?
Yes.
Measure the performance. Find out the difference. If 10 students appear the exam, what is the difference between these 10 students? Out of 10 students, 5 students secure 90% mark. 3 students secure 70% mark. And other 2 students secure 50% mark. What is the difference with them? Why the 2 students are not able to secure 70% mark? Or why 3 students are not able to secure 90% mark? And what make 5 students to secure 90% mark? The person must have to be differentiate. Measure the performance, find out the difference. And third one is take corrective action. Corrective action means the students who secure 50% mark should be awarded C grade. The students who secure 70% mark should be awarded B grade. And the students who secure 90% mark should be awarded A grade. That is the work of a controller. The controller will never award A grade to a student who secured 50% mark. If he do so, he cannot be a good controller. Do you follow me or not? So when we say that father is the controller of a family, then father is well acquainted with the activity, the performance of every member. And find out the difference. Why some people, the daughter is able to secure first division and why the son is not able to secure first division? Do you follow me or not? Then third one is take corrective action. Take corrective action. Action should be taken immediately according to the performance. Then only he will be a good controller. In an organization, there are different workers. And their working style is different. So the good workers, effective workers, or competent workers are promoted. Less competent workers are transferred. And incompetent workers are demoted, or suspended, or terminated. Clear? So the work of a controller in an organization plays a vital role in order to carry out the objective of the organization, to achieve the objective of the organization. So in an organization level, you can say that planning, organizing, directing, and controlling are one of the important functions of an organization. Without planning, without organizing, without directing, without controlling, no organization exists in this earth. If an organization is there, whether it is a commercial organization or non-commercial organization, whether it is a private organization or government organization, whether it is a software organization or a public sector organization, every organization to be effective, to be good, must have to follow planning, organizing, directing, and control. Clear? Tell me, what is difficulty with you? Where is difficulty? I will clarify.
Yes.
Is there any difficulty with the functions of an organization?
No, sir.
Good. Now you know introduction, meaning, definition, features, functions. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Then come to principles of an organization, another chapter. Last chapter of today's class. Principles of an organization. Yes. Tell me, what do you mean by principles? Principles. principles.
The rules and guidelines.
Rules and guidelines. Okay. But you will get 30% mark. Rules and guidelines. Mahatma Gandhi was a principal man. Do you agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Why?
Yes, sir.
Why do you agree? Mahatma Gandhi was like our person, like we people. Why he is a principal man? Why others are not called as principal men? Traffic principle say that everyone should lead to left. Traffic principle say that everyone should lead to left. But all the riders are desiring, are interested to ride on right. Why it is so? Why it is so? A rider know that he should lead to left, but often he lead to right. What will be the situation? What will be the result?
Sir, accident occur.
Occur? You are riding a bike. And you know that traffic principle say that you must lead to left. But riders are often lead to right. Result is, chances are there, he or she may reach the destination at an earlier. And another chance is, he or she may face accident at any time.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So if all the riders will follow the principle that they will not lead on right, they will lead on left only, then everyone will reach at their destination safely without any accident. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
So what principle is?
Obeying the rules and regulations.
Exactly, right. If you follow the rules and regulations, if you adhere to the rules and regulations, if you will obey the rules and regulations, it will become principle, otherwise not. Do you follow me or not?
Yes,
maximum people are not follow the rules and regulations. And if rules and regulations are not followed, it cannot become a principle. And Mahatma Gandhi is a principle person who always follow all the rules and regulations of a mankind. Do you follow me or not?
Yes,
all the principles. You might have seen, you might have known that the teacher insists him to make copy from the other student during the examination. Mahatma Gandhi didn't. Did he make copy? No, because he know the rules and regulation. Follow the rules and regulation of an examination. Now, the teachers are exhausting their time and instruct the students and be vigilant how the student will not make copy. And the students are always searching the scope how to make a copy in the exam. Do you follow me or not?
Yes,
so
sir.
Principles are when the rules and regulations are followed, are adhered, are taken into consideration. If rules and regulations are not followed, then it can become a principle. So in developing countries like India, many organizations are established and they are ruined due to not following of principles. But in developed countries, organizations are there and they follow the principles, so they exist. You follow me or not? So organization must have to follow some rules and regulations, and those rules and regulations, if followed, those become the principles of an organization, and organization having principles are successful organizations. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Hello, let us see what are those principles. Write down. The following are some of the principles of an organization. The following are some of the principles of an organization. One, division of work. Authority and responsibility. Second.
Authority and
responsibility. Equity. 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 Equity.
Okay.
Remuneration. Discipline. Stability. Unity. Okay. These are some of the principles of an organization. Organization must have to follow. Let us come one by one. Division of work. What do you mean by that?
Assignment of work to different parts in the organization.
According to their
designation, qualification and capabilities.
Knowledge and expertise. Okay?
Okay.
The specialization. Division of work refers to job specialization. If a worker is competent enough to do the work, allot him the work, otherwise don't allot him the work. Clear? If a nurse will do the work of a doctor, then the fate of the patient you know well. So in a hospital, the objective is how to relieve a patient. And the principle should be, the patient should be attended by the doctor and facilitated by the nurse. You follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
If nurse will be alerted to a patient, then the fate of the patient you know well. The objective of the organization cannot be possible. Principle. Follow the rules. In an education institution, teaching should be alerted to the teacher. If a demonstrator or a supervisor will allot the work of teaching, you know the fate of the students and the condition of teaching and learning process of that organization. Okay? So, yes. the first principle of an organization is allot the work to the most deserved one, to the most competent one, that is known as a division of work, job specialization, right man in a right place. Dear,
yes,
if a civil engineer will be appointed as a software engineer,
no,
you know well, yeah. So yes. Right man should be in a right place. Students, learners, whenever you go, now government is emphasizing more on skill development. Why it is so? Whoever may be. Whether he is a teacher, whether he is a doctor, whether he is an engineer, whether he is a scientist, whether he is a cobbler, whether he is a carpenter, is a tailor, whoever may be, he or she must have to develop his skill. Skill development is the primary requirement of an organization now. If you can develop your skill, that can be possible when right man in a right place. That is known as division of work, job specialization. Rule and regulation of the organization should be, right men should be in a right place. You might have known that. What is the fate of Congress party now? A big organization. The oldest political organization of our country. Now, in what shape? Because right men are not in a right place. You follow me or not? That is one of the principles of an organization. Come to authority and responsibility. Authority and responsibility, two words. What do you mean by authority and what do you mean by responsibility?
Sir, authority means the power or right to give orders, make decisions.
Right. Responsibility means?
Responsibility means our duty.
Duty is the responsibility. Responsibility is something different. Authority and responsibility are one of the principles of an organization. Go to a bank. Go to a bank. You will find the branch manager will arrive earlier and goes later. The clerk will come later and go earlier. Why it is so? Why it is so?
The
branch manager is an employee and a clerk is also an employee. But the branch manager arrives earlier and goes later. Whereas a clerk arrives later and goes earlier. Authority and responsibility go side by side in an organization. The principle of an organization say authority and responsibility are two sides of a coin. Go side by side. If you have more authority, you should have more responsibility also. More is the authority, more should be responsibility, and vice versa. No organization, no good organization in the earth can be succeed when there is authority more and responsibility is less. Authority is more, you should bear more responsibility. And if authority is less, you have less responsibility. I am giving an example. Manmohan Singh. Responsible for the corrupt practice of the Congress ministers. But Manmohan Singh was not a corrupt person. Why is he considered as a weak prime minister? Due to authority and responsibility. Because prime minister is responsible for the cabinet of ministers. If some of the cabinet ministers are corrupted, then prime minister should be considered as a corrupt prime minister. Because he has the authority, he has the responsibility. You follow me or not? Parliament is an organization. Think of our family. Father is responsible for an ideal family. If a father direct properly or control properly and all his sons and daughters are in good place, then credit goes to father. The reason is father is the authorized person and father is responsible. If a family is not ideal, then all the claim or all the defamation go to father. Because due to father, sons and daughters are corrupted, are not well. You follow me or not? So in an organization, authority and responsibility go side by side. More is the authority, more is the responsibility. Branch manager is the authorized person of a branch. So he has more responsibility. So he comes earlier and goes. In a clerk, the authority is less in a bank. So his responsibility also comparatively less. So he can go earlier and comes later. So in this way, principle of organization say authority and responsibility are side by side of an organization. More is the authority, more should be responsibility and vice versa. If a person enjoys more authority, he must have to bear more responsibility. Follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then next. Okay. Next is?
Equity.
What does it mean? Equal. There must be a equality among all the employees of the organization.
So the organization should not consider. Company.
Organization should not consider that the work of a managing director is more important than the work of a sweeper. The role of a watchman is not necessary, but the role of a chairman is more necessary. This should not be the consideration. All are equal in the organization point of view. The sweeper has its own role. The watchman has its own role. The managing director has its own role. The chairman has its own role. The chairman is equally important. The importance of a watchman also.
theaters, amphitheaters.
The work of a managing director is more important than the work of a sweeper also.
As much as 2,000 rooms.
Okay.
Madhav, this class has been rescheduled to tomorrow, 10:30. Because there is some technical problem at the end of counselor. So please join tomorrow at 10:30 and today, for today, you please log out. Not going to be held due to problem at the end of counselor.
Okay.
Equity. There must be equal responsibility. There must be equal. Everyone should be considered equal before the organization level. No one should consider superior and no one should be considered inferior in the organization level. The contribution of everyone is equally important for the organization. The role of a watchman is equally important the role of a chairman. The service of a sweeper is equally important for the organization to the service of a managing director. Do you follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
Then next one is
remuneration.
Remuneration. What do you mean by remuneration?
Salary.
Yes. The money paid for work or service.
All the right down. Financial benefit provided to a worker from time to time. Remuneration. Financial benefit provided to a worker from time to time. Remuneration. The principle say, not a single worker of the organization should be deprived of remuneration. No one should be allowed in the organization to work without any remuneration. But there must be a rule. There must be a regulation. What that rule and regulation say? That rule and regulation say that competent person should get more remuneration. Incompetent person should get less remuneration. The financial benefit of an experienced person should be more than the financial benefit of an inexperienced person. The salary and other benefits should be given to a higher qualified person than the lower qualified employee. If that rules and regulation will be followed, then only remuneration will be proper. So in an organization level, remuneration is a principle. And the principle say that every employee should get remuneration on the basis of their knowledge and expertise. The financial benefit should be provided to an employee on the basis of their qualification, on the basis of their knowledge, on the basis of their expertise. Clear?
Yes.
The next principle.
Discipline.
Discipline. No, well, very clear. Discipline must be there. Every employee should be disciplined. They should not follow. They should obey the rules and regulations for the organization. Whatever rules and regulations are framed by the organization, they must obey that. Without obeying, disobeying of rules and regulations make a worker indisciplined. Every worker must have to follow whatever rules and regulations. And rules and regulations are different. From organization to organization. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Next. What is the next principle?
Stability.
Stability. This is another principle of an organization. Every organization must be a stable organization. The employee should not fear. The employee should not doubt, the employee should not reluctant that he or she may lose his job. The organization will be closed down. The organization will not give his salary. The fear psychosis should be wiped out of the employee. The employee should not feel that he will or she will lose the work. So it is said that government works are more stable, or government organizations are more stable than private organizations. You know the reason? The reason is, it is very difficult to get a job in government organization and very difficult to lose a job also in the organization, government organization. On the other hand, it is very easy to get a job in private organization and very easy to also lose the job in a private organization. So government organizations are more stable than private organization. It is said that if an employee will feel free, if an employee will feel stable, if an employee will feel safe in the hands of the organization, then his efficiency can increase. And with the help of efficient employees, organization can prosper. So stability is another principle of an organization, which say that every employee should feel free, every employee should feel safe, every organization should not make doubt about the stability, the condition, the continuation, the prosperity of an organization. Clear?
Yes, sir. Unity.
Unity?
Unity.
You know well? United, we will stand. Divided, we will fall. That's the principle of unity. Every employee should work towards achievement of organization goal. I have told you the example of a family. Family is an organization. A lone father cannot make a family ideal. The contribution of every member of the family, father, mother, son, daughter, uncle, aunt, sweeper, watchman, everyone. Their contribution should be, they should work unitedly how to make family ideal, so that an ideal family can be possible. So when ideal family is necessary, it is required that every member of the family should work unitedly. Likewise, in an organization, irrespective of post and position, irrespective of their work, irrespective of their nature of duty, every member in the organization, every worker in the organization should work unitedly for achievement of objective. Then only it can be a successful organization. If alone branch manager will say, if alone managing director will say, if only chairman will say, I will make organization stable, it cannot. It is impossible. Every employee, every worker should work unitedly for the benefit of the organization, for achievement of objective of the organization, then only it can be a successful organization. Okay?
Okay, sir.
What else?
Nothing.
These are the principles of an organization. So, you know, introduction, meaning, definition, features, functions, then
principles.
Okay. So with this, today's class comes to an end. Tell me, any doubt with you?
No, sir.
So when you know the organization, then only know organizational behavior. Okay, I will give you some introduction about organizational behavior today because 10 more minutes is there with me. Okay. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by behavior? What do you mean by behavior? Tell me. Behavior is a very simple word. Behavior. Don't misbehave me. We should behave properly to our elders. Your behavior does not suit me. What do you mean by that?
The way we treat others and respond to the situation.
No. When someone say, you misbehave me. When someone say, your behavior is acceptable to me, or you show a good behavior, or your behavior is good. What is the difference between your behavior is good and while your behavior is bad? Your behavior is acceptable and your behavior is not acceptable. What is the difference between two factors? Behavior. Write out. Behavior refers to the way you present before others. The way one present before others. Now you know what behavior is?
Yes, sir.
Your presentation before others is your behavior. You follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
If your presentation before others is acceptable, it is good behavior. And if it's not acceptable, it is bad behavior. You follow me or not?
Yes, sir.
So when always one desires, one always accepts, one always desires that one should give a good behavior. That means everyone should present before others in a good way, or in an acceptable way, or in an acceptable manner. So that represents one's behavior. If your presentation is not acceptable to other, then you show a bad behavior to him or her. And if your presentation is acceptable, then you show a good behavior to him or her. Likewise, organization behavior say or teaches us how an employee should represent himself, how an employee should behave himself, how an employee should be in the organization so that the organization will be acceptable or his representation will be acceptable to the organization. You follow me or not?
Yes.
Organization consists of different employees. We have known that. Different members. Because one person cannot form an organization. So when a group of persons work in an organization, they represent each other. And their representation should be acceptable to each other. If it is not acceptable to each other, then it is known as organizational misbehavior. And when it's acceptable to each other, it is known as organizational behavior. Clear? So what organizational behavior is? Write down. Meaning of organizational behavior. Organizational behavior refers to organizational behavior refers to representation of every employee. Representation of every employee of an organization.
Of an organization.
So that each employee, so that each employee should be acceptable. By every employee. In general sense, organizational behavior refers to those activities of an employee which is
again
which is acceptable for the benefit of the organization. Benefit of the organization. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, organizational behavior say how the employees would work, how the employees would behave, how the employees will represent themselves before the organization, so that the organization will get benefit out of that. Clear? Next class, we will study detail about organizational behavior, scope, elements, nature, necessity, definition, and why organizational behavior is important in Indian context.
Okay. Tomorrow class 9 a.m. on.
Tomorrow from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Go through the teaching of today. Go through the notes of today. Go through the study material with you. And if you face any problem of this class, ask me tomorrow. I will clarify those doubts and proceed for the next class.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.